How's everybody doing today? I certainly hope you're doing well. I don't know about you, but I'm an invisible American. I sure am. And the reason why I'm invisible is because, well, I can't be seen, I can't be heard no matter what I do. If I protest in the street, I'm deemed as a terrorist somehow. They're always snapping little pictures or getting video of you. So they can put you on some kind of list. Because it's un-American anymore to protest now, isn't it? Oh, absolutely. You know, you're supposed to be a good little invisible American and just not be seen. When we want to deal with you, when we want, your money, believe me, we'll send the IRS to come and get it. And, when we want you to fall in line and you don't, then we'll send the DHS to come deem you as some sort of terrorist and kick down your door because of the passage of the NDAA. But hey, you're invisible. And it's best that you just stay invisible because we don't want to deal with you. We just don't want to deal with you. Listen, the people that are making the decisions up in Washington, the comptroller, the people that are making the financial decisions of America, it is best that you just sit on your fat ass, eat your ding dongs, and watch your television, get on the internet and play. Because we do not want to deal with you. You are supposed to be invisible. All right? That's all there is to it. As soon as we can, we're going to take every one of your freedoms away, every last one of them away. And then, of course, when Americans speak out, then they raise hell and say, "You can't do that." What happens? All of these three-letter agencies will sit there and tell you, "Well, yes, we can." And they have. And they will continue to do it. And there's nothing that you're going to do about it because you're invisible, aren't you? You're invisible. You are not to be seen. You are not to be heard. You're only there when they need you. Because you have different government agencies like the TSA, the Transportation Safety Administration, right? These ding dongs are at these airports and such. And they're feeling up your grandma, or they're feeling up some gal in a wheelchair, or who knows what. And for what? Does it have anything to do with security? Absolutely not. It has everything to do with profits. Profits of the selling of those machines that we don't even need. It's garbage. It's a facade. It's all about control. Know it. The unemployment rate in this country, the government will tell you all day long the unemployment rate is only at 9.7%, and we all know that it's at 20% or even greater. But yet, all of these different corporations, because we live in a fascist state, the marriage of corporations and government creates fascism. We are living in a fascist state. So all these big hot dogs are taking our jobs and they're sending them overseas so they can pay this guy $10 or $8 or $4 an hour for a job that you used to carry at $35 an hour, at $15 an hour, at $18 an hour. And for what? For profits. But I'm going to tell you something right now. I'm going to give you an opportunity as an invisible American to do something about it. If you send me $35 right now, I will send you this cutest little thing to put on your wrist. Phony 2012. That's right. Because, if you want this sort of thing to continue, you have got to have a phony in office. And this man has proven to be the biggest phony of all time. Yes, if you send me $35, I'll send you the phony bracelet, and you can wear it everywhere with you. Everywhere. Because after all, you're invisible.
Hey, this fooled me once. Shame on you. You fooled me, we can't get fooled again.
Those weapons of mass destruction got to be somewhere.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.